do a quick haul of some of the new stuff that I bought. That's like the biggest disappointment of it all.
They're too big.
Keep my clasps in this box.
This is the regular size of a necklace clasp.
Oh, they look the same. Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Let me show you. But it's humongous.
The whole restock is dependent on this. That's why I'm always skeptical when I buy new products. Girl. Alright, I have to see if it really affects the quality of the overall product, because if it does, then I don't know what I'm gonna do. And I have to make some new jewelry, and I have to shoot some stuff, but it's not like a lot of stuff that I have to shoot. I think it's just three new products. I'm still thinking about the size of these clasps, because they seem so huge. I would love to do an unboxing of the new grit. But unfortunately, the shippers already did that for me. If I fold this plastic. Woman in STEM.
Nikki, what did you think?
Amazing, as always. So good.
Innovator.
Okay, clasp check.
I love that these come in a little own organization, like one of these. But it's alphabet beads. I specifically chose these because they're gold, so I feel like they look more on the upside. I got more wire that I desperately needed. 24 gauge, which I use for small wrapping. And this is 18 gauge, which is a lot thicker. These are the gemstones that I bought to make some new necklaces. I only bought rose quartz. You smiled and talked to me of nothing. And I felt for this, I had been waiting long. Okay, English isn't their first language, but I appreciate that. So cute. The tumbler takes about 3 weeks to do an entire batch. I bought them pre-tumbled and polished. What else I have to unbox? Oh, earring box. Oh, there's more tape. What the yeek. Okay. But these letters are gorgeous. Are you kidding me? That's it for unboxing news. When using these grids, in order to prevent grit from entering your eyes and mouth, we recommend that you wear goggles and a mask. Do not pour used grit and ceramic filler into the toilet! Exclamation mark. Please do not swallow it. Let's get down to business.
No more fooling around.
See y'all when I'm breaking glass. Ooh, I need the hammer. Okay, this is gonna be fun.
Let's get down to business. Give you one more night to get this. We've had a million, million nights just like this. So let's get down to business. Mama, please don't worry about me. Mama, about to let my heart speak.
Of all the glass flying, glass flew in my shoe. I cut my hand on the packaging. The packaging! Ugh. I can't believe it's the packaging. I'm here.
Hey.
Hello. Anyways, the first thing I like to do is prepare the packaging. And let's start with this order first. This one is bad jewelry, so I'm gonna be doing metal stamping. I strap my metal to the stamping block with masking tape, and I'm gonna go outside to engrave that ring and bracelet. We're back and it's stamped. But yeah, I like this method because it's pretty simple. I was thinking even maybe one day in the future I get like a glow forge and do like a real engraving, like not hand done but machine cut. But as for right now, it's just simple, cute, affordable jewelry. So that's our ring done. And I think before I said bracelet, it's actually an anklet order. This customer had her specific measurement. She said 9.5 inches. So I had to make sure to get everything 9.5 inches in total, including the extension link. Actually, I think, girl, I don't know. I can't remember. This was 2 weeks ago. I'm sorry. But yeah, that anklet order I put together real cute, real nice. The next orders were two of my new pieces of jewelry called the Aurora necklaces. I did it off camera, not because I was trying to like, you know, hide the method or anything. It's just because like out of comfort, you know, being over the camera and leaning, and you know, I didn't want to mess it up. It was a new piece, so it's not like I made it 1,000 times before. So I made them off camera in comfort, and I also made this beaded ring.
all white, right? Couldn't hit it if niggas had eyes.
I don't even think I could record in here because of the tumbler, it's so loud.
Lanes can't call and you lying. You had it and you lost all the time. I can buy Billy, don't talk to me.
I wasn't able to make the new products last night because I was super stressed out along there at the end of the day. So I just launched the restock. You know, I got back in here, I can't. I didn't even try the alphabet new beads, the choker thing, anything. But I'm gonna try it tonight. And I have two posts to post tonight, the giveaway winner. And a reel that I made since I launched the mini drop of these new products. The reel was just like, how to measure your ring size. I kind of feel weird about it because my voice isn't on the page and this is like my voice. Talking, so it's like voice reveal, but I don't know. It's the last reel I made in the batch of reels. I think I mentioned before, I stayed up to like 3 a.m. making like a whole bunch of batch content, edited them the following day, and I had them like sitting in my draft up until now. I was actually playing on screen.
Hey shoppers, let's make the fairy godmother necklace.
Together and what have you got?
Yeah, so I made that reel along with like 5 other reels. Y'all, I know it's about the jewelry. Well, it's a week in my life to be honest, so it's gonna be about everything. My hair. My go-to has been just to wear it out because it's the easiest thing. Once I finish washing it, I put them in twists, and then I can wear the twists for like a week. Put them in one, put them there, put them there, put them anywhere. And then when I'm finished with the twists, like I'm done with them, I just take them out and then my hair's like this big, nice, fluffy twist up, which is this. And then I do like, you know, just wear it out. But that's real lazy. But I wanna try new styles because I used to be a style girl. I used to wear new hairstyles to school every single day in college. Like, where's Leah? We've lost Leah. So we're gonna find Leah. So I'm gonna try to style my hair. I used to try to do half a pop down with my short hair, but I never liked it. Too much of my side, my hair was like this, and too much of this was exposed and stuff. So I like that this like hugs my hair now, especially with the new jewelry. Like, it's, do you pick up what I'm putting down? I'm not gonna bore y'all with me doing my hair. I'm just gonna cut it hair. I'm sorry if you wanted to see me do my hair, but I gotta keep the video centered about the jewelry, kind of, in a way. I brought out my lights and I'm gonna shoot them tonight. Honestly, I'm gonna film my, this has to come out because this smooth doesn't go good with the smooth and the out. So this is gonna be out. But anyways, I'm gonna finish my hair in the vehicle because it's hot. Today I got one order, yesterday I had 3. My goal for this week is to have at least one order every single week. So I'm carrying in one order plus the giveaway winner's order for the restock. So yeah. Everything happens for a reason though, because if I had kept going, kept walking throughout the day and stuff, I would have become obsessed, obsessive work, trying to search for the right results. So it's a good thing. Throughout the day, I'm gonna take a break, and then when I get back home later today at like 5, I'll get back to editing and stuff, but I'm just gonna drop everything shop all day related. These are the edits that came out of some work that I did. These are the pictures I took on the camera, girl. Stunning, crystal clear. This is just a divider between pictures of a post. So this is one post, which is gonna be about these bracelets, brand spanking new. And then another post starts here. I decided to call this like the Shop Aldea experience, or the Aldea experience, because it's the first time that I'm posting multiple new products in one single post. In the caption, I put browse through the lookbook. I haven't posted it as yet. I'll show you guys when I post it tonight, because now it's 4:35, which is a bad time to post. Nobody, like, people getting home from work. If you didn't know, my business is like central based in St. Vincent and the Grenadines. It's not worldwide shipping, so I have to base my timing on winter time. Oh, I'm at my goal so far, but I don't know, it depends on how this thing goes tonight.
it's not looking too good with the gold. Everything is just slow in terms of sales lately. I don't think all the inflation, groceries going up and stuff, I don't think people like splurging on jewelry and stuff unless it's for a special occasion, buying something for like their friend's birthday. So sales have been slow. I need to get at least one order tonight. If I miss the order, then I miss my goal, but that's okay. We keep moving, we gonna keep pushing. I'm on a coffee ban
now, playing Cafe IT by Beyonce on Apple Music.
Okay, let's be serious. All right, I don't have much to say, but I'm gonna say a lot. Okay, at first I thought it was my fault. I felt like I was doing something wrong, like my marketing was off or something, but I'd done that in the past. What did I call it? The body collection. I think I called it the body collection, and it was just a collection of waist chains. I marketed it terribly. I went straight to the beach idea. I don't think that was the way, but I know that one was my fault. I feel like if I did it in a different direction, the results would have been different. But this time, I feel like it's out of my hands, and I finally accepted that, like, it's completely out of my hands. But yeah, honestly, if it was not false to the economic crisis and it was like something falling on me, or me doing something wrong, or you know, then I would have felt some type of way. It's not over, but it's heading in a different direction. I don't know what the future of this shop is. From the very minute I started it, I never really knew what the future was. Explaining it every time is kind of difficult. Starting the shop was never an intention, it was never a dream of mine, it was never a lifelong goal. I like to say it's God, or if you believe in the universe or whatever you believe in, but for me it's God. Faith is a great way to describe it, but I would like to say it's the big man. The way things go for me is like never planned. The only venture that I have as my lifelong goal, and I believe that's why the journey is so long and not rewarding right away, because it's my lifelong goal, and it's YouTube. Other than that, my cartoons and animation, that was like automatic win situation. I never even thought about it, never thought twice, never planned it. The jewelry, automatic win situation, never thought twice about it, just happened. You could say it's my destiny or whatever. Yeah, when I'm placed in that situation, I just simply continue to do my best at it, because I refuse to do anything mediocre. So I just do what I could do my best, and it's a lot of fun too. Planning those shoots, planning your jewelry, releasing it, seeing people's reactions is like so much fun, and it really truly came, and it's gonna come from the heart. It's not over yet. This week honestly has been, I don't know, and I didn't capture much of it in the video, but last night was a full moon. I was up until 3 a.m. I was going through it. Okay. Edit, edit, upload, pack, and then probably get some kind of sleep. And I'm also speaking to this customer. I did another order for her. Okay, I'm not even sure where this video is going or how to end it. I don't think I even completed my thought process from the little rant before, but I was basically saying that I didn't have a long-term goal for it, so I don't know where to go with it now. But I feel as though Shop Alia was never really the main focus. It was always Studio Alia, which is like the art overall. I don't know if you follow me on like all my platforms, you'll be more familiar with what I'm speaking about. But yeah, so the studio isn't going anywhere. The jewelry might be heading in a different direction. I'm not sure what will happen. We'll see when I get back from school, because I'm leaving the country anyways. Besides that, as you see, I was having like a crazy stupid night. I don't know what's going on. This is the result from the glass tumbler. Yeah. I'm just gonna end this video here. I have no idea what's going on. Thanks for watching. Bye. What the heck? Okay, I'm out.